Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. So as per schedule, we are starting our optional mathematics class. And I have already sent to you the questions of our today's class, right? So I do hope you have copied those questions. So let me take you to the board, okay? So these are the questions that we will be solving today. So first of all, copy this one, a number. This was the question that was given to you as assignment, right? But many students were asking me about this. So I am going to repeat it in our today's lecture. So this is very easy one. And let me repeat you again. Up to this question, the questions are only of 2 marks. So we have very short and sweet method for this question, okay? Have you copied it? So let's solve, okay? And it is a question of 2 marks. Let me repeat it to you. So first of all, write question number A, left hand side. It says sine theta plus sec theta all square, right? All square plus cos theta plus cosec theta all square. The question is like this. So for solving, let us look the right hand side first. Look at the right part. Would you have sec theta and cosec theta? And again, look at the left part. There is sine sec and cos cosec, right? So I think now you might be clear. This and these terms are not needed in right part, right? Because we have only sec, which is over here, and we have cosec, which is over here. So let's remove or convert sine and cos into cosec and sec. So this will be our first step. The first step will be sine theta is 1 by cosec theta. Is this clear? And sec theta is as it is, because we do have this in our right part. Similarly, cos theta can be written as 1 by sec theta, right? And cosec theta will be as it is, because this one is needed in right part. So this is our first step. You are getting it right. The sine has been converted into cosec and cos has been converted into sec. Is this clear? So now it's time to take LCM, or you can say cross multiply. Do like this. It will be 1 plus this will multiply to sec, right? So it will be sec theta dot cosec theta, right? This is called cross multiplication. And in the denominator part, we do have cosec theta as it is, right? This is called taking LCM, and the whole square remains as it is. So the plus is over here, which was in the middle part, right? And in this part, let us take the LCM again. Sec will multiply to cosec. So it will be 1 plus sec theta cosec theta. Is this clear? And in denominator part, we do have sec as it is, right? And do not forget to write square. Is this clear up to here? In first step, we converted sine to cosec, cos into sec. Why? Because this was our demand of RHS, right? And we just took the LCM, and it looks like this. Now, I think you might have a great observation. Look over here. The numerator part is exactly same. Look at here. So these two can be taken as common. Let me show you it in the form of algebra, simple algebra first. Look at here. If we have a square by b square plus a square by c square, then how can we take common? We can take it common as, you can take a square as common, right? So first in this part, a square has already been taken. So 1 will remain, and in the denominator part, it will be b square. And the plus of the middle part is as it is. In the right part, as a square has already been taken common, so it will be 1. And in the denominator part, it will be c square. This will be our final structure. This is called taking common from the numerator part without disturbing denominator. So follow the same condition over here. Let us take numerator common, okay? So it will be 1 plus sec theta cosec theta, right? This will be taken as common. Not only this, with power, right? Because we have a square as well. So let us put a big bracket over here. And now tell me, in numerator, this part with square has already been taken common. So one will be left, right? And in denominator part, we do have cosec theta. Are you getting it? And with square, because this square is for both numerator and denominator, right? Because it is whole bracket. So numerator has been taken as common and denominator has been left as it is with square, because this whole square refers to the square of numerator and denominator both. Is it clear? So plus of the middle is over here, right? And in the right part, we again have one, because the numerator has been taken as common. And in the denominator part, we will have sec theta left, right? Along with whole square, because this square is for both. So now look at here, it becomes like this. In first step, we did a reciprocal relation. And in the second one, we took LCM. And in third one, we took common with square without disturbing the numerator. And don't forget to write square over here. Are you clear up to this? Now, copy this as it is. 1 plus sec theta cosec theta whole square, right? But in this part, you know, right? 1 by cosec means sine, right? It will be now sine square theta, because square is also over here. And the plus will be as it is. And the next part here is 1 by sec. And 1 by sec means cos theta, right? So it will be cos theta, but with square, because here is square as well. And let's close the bracket. This is very simple, right? We have just used the formula. 1 by cosec means sine, 1 by sec means cos. And now I think we are very near to the answer, right? Because this remains as it is. This is as it is, right? With whole square. And this will be 1. Why? Because sine square theta plus cos square theta will be equal to 1. Are you clear? And now finally we are up to here. 1 plus sec cosec whole square into 1. So this has no meaning over here. So it will be 1 plus sec theta cosec theta whole square. This is our right hand side. Is this clear? This is question of 2 marks. This even can be solved by very lengthier process, but do it in a short way. Is this clear? This is clear, right? So I am showing this you as a whole. So can I rub it now? Raise your hands if I can rub it. I can rub it, right? No. I'm leaving few seconds, okay? Do it faster. Copy it now. If you are not getting any type of steps or say kind of solving techniques, then you can ask me in personal chat, okay? Can I rub it now? Raise your hands, please. I can drop it, okay? So copy the next question. This is our second question. Copy the B. This was also assignment of previous lecture, right? 1 plus sine A plus cos A whole square is equal to 2 bracket 1 plus sine A, bracket closed, and next bracket 1 plus cos A, and again closed, right? This is our second question. And even this question is of 2 marks, and it is also a very short one. Copy the question. And during that time, I'll rub my board, okay? Copy the question faster, okay? And if you have already done your assignment, then it's better to do it again. This question, okay? Because I'll teach you the shorter method. And doing the question twice does not do any harm, right? It'll be just a practice for you. So let's move to the next question. Question B, and our LHS is, right, LHS first, our LHS is 1 plus sine A plus cos A whole square. This is our left hand side, okay? And look the right part first. We have here 2, 1 plus sine, 1 plus cos. This much only. So again to the solution part. I think we must apply A plus B whole square, right? So before that, let's decide A and B first. Suppose this is our A. It is not writing. Just a second. No. This is our A, okay? This whole part is our A and this whole part is our B. Suppose like this, okay? 1 plus sine A consider it as A and consider this cos A as B. So let's use the formula A plus B whole square. Now it will be A square plus 2AB plus B square, right? This will be our format. Is this clear? A square plus 2AB plus B square. And in place of A, we will write 1 plus sin A, right? 1 plus sin A, because this is our A. And here we are about to write 2AB. So right here, A, and this is our B, right? 2AB. And here is our B square. So it will be cos A whole square. Now this is in the form of A square plus 2AB plus B square. Are you clear? This is very simple one. So let's move to the next step. And in the next one, keep this first term as it is. Now it will be 1 plus sin A whole square. Is this clear? This is very easy one. And in this part, do nothing. Just copy as it is. Sin A, cos A. Even this has been copied as it is, right? And in the third part, we have here cos square A. This means cos square A, right? This and cos square A have the same meaning. Are you clear? So cos square A can be written as, you know the formula, right? It can be written as 1 minus sin square A. Are you clear? This one is for this term. Are you clear? I have written cos square A as 1 minus sin square A. Is this clear? And I think you are very much clear that 1 can be written as 1 square, right? Because 1 and 1 square have same meaning. So look at the next step. Copy the first part as it is. 1 plus sin A. It is as it is, right? 2, 1 plus sin A. This is again as it is. Cos A again as it is. And now we have A square minus B square format, right? So let me write it with the red ink. Now it will be A square minus B square format. Now A square minus B square will be A plus B, A minus B, right? So it will be A plus B and A minus B. Are you clear? Look at this clearly. Let me drop the unnecessary part first. Just a second, okay? So look at here. In this part, we have converted cos square as 1 minus sin square. And 1 means 1 square itself, right? So A square minus B square will be A plus B, A minus B. Are you clear up to here? Now you have very much clear observation. Look at here carefully. There is 1 plus sin A in third part. And even in the second part, there is 1 plus sin A. And even in the first part, we do have 1 plus sin A. Right, so we can take it as common. Is this clear? Look at here. 1 plus sin A whole square means there are 2 1 plus sin A, right? In multiply form. There is also 1 plus sin, there is also 1 plus sin. In three terms. So let us take 1 plus sin A as common. So now this will be 1 plus sin A common. Okay, this one is taken as common. And in the first part, look at here carefully. Can you tell me what will remain? If you take 1 plus sin A as common, then you will have another 1 plus sin A. Because there is a square, right? So from first term, you will have 1 plus sin A as remaining. Is this clear? And this is the plus sign of here. Circled one. And in second term, you have already taken this as common. So now you have 2, these 2 and this cos A left, this is left, right? And in third term, you have taken this as common. So now you have 1 minus sin A left. So it will be plus 1 minus sin A. Are you clear? This is clear, right? And this plus is over here. I have circled the signs, right? Look at here again. We took 1 plus sin A common from all three terms. Is this clear? So from here, if you take 1 plus sin A common, then the next 1 plus sin A will be remaining. And in this part, as these have been already taken common, this 2 and cos A will be left over here. And this plus is over here. And you have already taken this one common. So our last part will remain as it is. Is this clear? So this is super clear, right? and these two are getting cancelled. Look at here, because sign A in positive part, this has a positive sign and this has a negative sign. So these two will be cancelled. Okay, now we will get 1 plus sine A as it is, right? And in this part, you can add this one and this one. Look at here. Here is 1. This is positive 1. And even this one is positive. So 1 and 1 added becomes 2, right? This will be 2. And we have just a single term left, 2 cos A, right? 2 cos A left. 2 cos A is left. Are you clear? Look at here. The 2 sine A has been cancelled because sine A plus and sine A minus, these two can be cancelled very easily. And this 1 and 1 has been added, have been added, because these both are having positive signs. And this 2 cos A is remaining as it is. Now, we are just very near to our answer. 1 plus sine A will be as it is, right? And from here, I think you can take 2 as common, because in both terms, the number 2 are same. So take 2 as common and you will have 1 plus cos A, right? You will have 1 plus cos A. And as these all three are in multiply sign, you can change the position of 2. So now you can put this 2 in the front part, 2, 1 plus sine A and 1 plus cos A. This will be our RHS. RHS. Are you clear? So let me show this to you. In first part, we decided A and B, right? A and B. Then we did open the whole square. And we converted the last part into sine. And we used A square minus B square format. And we took common from all three parts. And in the remaining part, we cancelled the two sines. And then just we added the two ones. And then we took the two as common. We have taken two as common, right? And just we shifted the two at the first part. Is this clear? So I've done this without jumping a single step. You can jump the minor steps as well. Are you clear up to here? So if you are clear, then raise with your hand. I'll rub the board. Can I rub the board? Thank you. So I want you to copy this question. First question. And in the heading, write long questions first. Write the heading, long questions. And this will be for about 4 marks. And sometimes even 5 marks has been asked from here. So normally, basically, this is of 4 marks. Copy the question. And this says 3 minus 4 sine square theta, bracket closed in both part, and 1 minus 3 sine square theta is equal to 3 minus sine square, 4 cos square minus 3. This is our question. And I think this has even been solved in our workout example. Copy the question, and this is very much important question, okay? And immediately after this, we will be solving this question, which is even similar to this one. Okay, just copy the question. Have you copied the question? Raise your hand if you have copied the question. You have copied, right? So let me rub the board first. While I'm rubbing the board, you can revise your formula or you can just revise the previous questions. And if you have any doubts, you can put it in the chat section, okay? Or you can ask me personally. And I want you all to do your assignments in time. If not, then the lectures will go waste. Because mathematics is a subject in which even students have to practice a lot, right? Just the effort by teacher will go in vain if you don't work well. So practice properly. So let's move to the long question. Write A, okay? And it has LHS first. And in LHS, we do have 3 minus 4 sine square theta, bracket closed, right? And 1 minus 3 tan square theta. This is our question. And this question is very much favorite of mine. So I have given it a pet name. And I want you to write that in your copy as well. This question is called denominator. Write the name. Denominator. Denominator exchange. Wala question. This is the pet name of this question. Denominator exchange wala question. Write it here. Because this is the key method to solve this type of question. Write the name. Denominator exchange wala question. Is this clear? And this is very famous question, okay? So I am giving the pet name as well. Clear up to here? So look at the question first. Now look the design of the question. Here is 3 minus 4 sine square, 1 minus 3 tan square. And even here, there is 3 minus tan square, 4 cos square minus 3. Means nothing is simple and nothing is complex. Even LHS has two terms in multiply form. And even this has the same pattern. So this is ditto exactly same. Either you solve from right part or left part. It's a similar question. That you can solve from right part as well or left part as well. This is exactly the same thing. So we are solving it from left part, okay? So now here, as I've told you, denominator exchange wala question. Now first, let me tell you which form has a significant denominator. This will be a sine by cos. This will be 1 by cosec. And look at here, in right part, we don't have cosec, right? We have no cosec. We have only cos and tan. So I think solving this will be easy. Because this will take us to sine by cos. And this is 1 by cosec. So don't reciprocal this. Use formula of tan. Okay. Now this will look like 3 minus 4 sine square theta. Copy it as it is. And in here, write 1 minus 3 sine square theta by cos square theta. Are you clear? This is for tan square theta. Okay. Now look at here. Now we got our denominator, right? This is our denominator. And I had told you to exchange the denominator. Now tell me, can you put this cos square to here? No. No, right? Look at this first. Look in the form of C mathematics algebra. Look at here. If you have A minus B by C, okay, into, suppose into B, D minus E, right? You can't put this C to here. Unless you take LCM. So what you can do for this is write D minus E as it is. And first take LCM, it will be AC minus B by C, right? This will be after LCM. Multiply this one first. Now you can exchange this C. Now you can write D minus E by C into AC minus B. Now this is correct. Now this can be done. Is this clear? Without taking LCM, you cannot exchange your denominator, but after taking LCM, you can exchange it. This is the main concept. So here we are trying to do the same. Is it clear? We are trying to exchange the denominator, but as we have not taken any LCM, so let's take LCM first. Now it will be now 3 minus 4 sine square theta, and after LCM it will be cos square into 1, right? It will be cos square theta minus 3 sine square theta. This is our LCM, right? And in denominator part, it will be cos square theta. Are you clear? This is our LCM form after taking LCM. Now our main step, denominator exchange. Now we will exchange the denominator like this. Take this cos square to this part. This is our main step. This is called hot step. Write in copy. Hot step means there is in every type of long question we have hot steps. Okay, now we are going to exchange the denominator and it will be our hot step, means the main step of our question. And before going to examination hall, you are suggested to revise this type of hot step for every questions. Is it clear? And for every kind of long questions, I will provide you the hot step. So now, after exchange of denominator, it will be 3 minus 4 sine square theta. And as we take this one to left part, it will be cos square theta, right? And in the right part, it is cos square theta minus 3 sine square theta. Are you clear? We have just taken this denominator to this one, or we have exchanged the denominator. Is this clear? This is clear, right? So now what we can do is just distribute the cos square. Now it will be 3 by cos square theta minus 4 sine square theta by cos square theta. You understand this, right? We have just distributed in two numerators. And in this part, in the right part, look at your RHS first. In RHS, look at here, we do have 4 cos square minus 3, right? This means we have no sine in RHS, we have only cos. So now look at here, we have cos and sine as well. So now I think you are clear, we must convert this sine because our RHS has no sine, right? So let's convert the sine. Now it will be cos square theta minus, now you must put the bracket as well, and there is 3 also, 1 minus cos square theta. Are you clear? Look at this properly. In this part, cos square is as it is because it is contained by RHS. Our 3 is over here as it is, and I have converted sine square into 1 minus cos square. Is this clear? This is clear, right? So now I think there is no space downwards. I should write at the top. Let me rub the question, okay? Because my space is getting dead. So just a few seconds. So now look at here. You can write 3 by cos square as 3 sec square. Is this clear? Because 1 by cos square will be sec square. So now it can be written as 3 sec square theta. Is this clear? Look at here again. 3 is as it is, and 1 by cos square will be sec square. Right? So minus is as it is. And look at here. There is 4 sine square by cos square. So sine square by cos square will be tan square, right? So you can write it here. 4 is as it is, and sine square by cos square will be tan square. Is this clear? So this is also clear, right? So in the right part, do it faster. In the right part, we do have cos square theta minus 3 bracket 1 minus cos square theta. Let us open the bracket. So now it will be cos square minus 3 plus 3 cos square, right? Plus 3 cos square. So now it will be, let me write it here, cos square theta minus 3 plus 3 cos square theta. We have just opened the bracket, but don't forget to multiply with minus sign. Is this clear up to here? So let me solve the right part first because it is easier, right? So now here we can write 3 cos square plus cos square. Look at here. 3 cos square plus cos square will be 4 cos square, right? And minus 3 is as it is. I think this is one part of RHS, right? So for next part, look at RHS again. Look at here. So here it is 3 minus tan square. But we have here tan square and sec square. So I think you have understood it. We must convert this sec square. So let us convert this first. Now we can write 3 and sec square theta will be 1 plus tan square theta, right? This is our standard formula. Are you clear? So the minus 4 and tan square theta is as it is. Did you get it? Look at there again. This cos square and 3 cos square has been added. These two have been added, and 1 plus 3 will be 4, right? And minus 3 is as it is at the end. And in first part, we converted sec into tan because our right hand side does not have sec. So we must convert into tan. So now open the bracket. We are at the end. Now it will be 3 plus 3 tan square theta minus 4 tan square theta, right? This is what it happens after opening the bracket. And in the right part, we do have 4 cos square theta minus 3, right? So now we can do simple calculation after this. So 3 is 3 as it is. Look at here, plus 3 minus 4. It will be minus 1, right? It will be minus tan square theta only. This simple calculation. 3 tan square theta minus 4 tan square theta, it will be a negative tan square theta. And in the right part, we have 4 cos square theta minus 3. Don't change it because this is our RHS. Right? So look at here again. Is this clear? And I don't have the full format of the question because I have already rubbed it. So look from the hurt step. In hurt step, you know, right? We first, what we did? Do you remember? We just converted sine tan into sine by cos. And here, we are taking LCM. Now we are exchanging our denominator. We took this cos square from right part to left part. right? So we again distributed this cos square into both numerators. Now it became 3 by cos square and 4 sine square by cos square. And in here, we have left cos square as it is, but converted sine square into cos square form and with using bracket as well. So this 3 will be as it is, and 1 by cos square will be our sec square, and sine square by cos square will be our tan square, and 4 is left as it is. And from here, we have opened the bracket by using minus 3. It will be minus 3 plus 3 cos square theta. Look at there, exactly the same. And looking the design of RHS, we converted our sec square into tan square, right? And we just converted, we just added these two and got this part. And we just opened the bracket and solved these two. And we finally got our answer. Is this clear? So remember this question as denominator exchange question. Without exchanging the denominator, this can't be solved. So be careful, okay? And we do have similar question here. Look at here. In the B part, we have 2 minus cos square, 1 plus 2 cot square is equal to 2 plus cot square bracket 2 minus sine square. Is this clear? This is a very simple question. And I think I should give it to you as assignment, okay? Because this type of question has been solved just few moments ago. So copy the question of B and try it as assignment. And if you couldn't do it, then I will help you. So as of now, let's do question number C. Copy the question. Question number C looks like this. Sec A minus tan A plus 1 whole upon 1 plus sec A plus tan A will give 1 minus sin A by cos A. This is also very much famous question. Look at this. Sec A minus tan A plus 1 whole upon 1 plus sec A plus tan A as our left hand side, and 1 minus sin A by cos A as our right hand side. Have you copied this? While you are copying the question, let me rub the board.
We have around 6 minutes left, sir.
We have very, very few time. I'll try to do as fast as I can. Okay. Catch me if you can. Just few seconds, okay? I'm rubbing the board. And it is very hard to rub the board because my hands are not free. I have to control this screen as well. So let's do the question, okay? I'll do in very rapid manner in the speed of light. So try to copy as fast as possible, okay? Let's do from left hand side. The question says, the question looks like this. Sec A minus tan A plus 1 upon 1 plus sec A plus tan A. This is our left hand side. Are you clear? And even for this question, I have given a pet name. It is One Ko Jadu, right? Ek Ko Jadu. Write the Nepali form. One Ko Jadu, right? This is magic of one. If you can use the one properly, then you will immediately get the answer. And one here means this one. Okay? And in our upcoming lecture also, we'll try to solve this type of question furthermore. So don't worry. We have again this type of question. We have many questions related to this format in our book. So don't worry. If you do not get these questions, particularly in this lecture, then I'll repeat this in our upcoming lecture. Okay. So for this one, we do have sec A minus tan A. Write this as it is. And we have the formula of one, right? Look at here. We have 1 as sec square minus tan square. Do you remember this? You know this, right? This 1 can be written as sec square minus tan square. Now you might ask me why I have used this formula. Because we do have sec and tan in our question. If there are sine and cos, we'd have used sine square plus cos square. Is this clear? So what is given in the front part? Use the one of same formula. This is our rule. Is this clear? So if you add cosec and cot over here, we would have written here cosec square minus cot square. So this is the format. Now copy the denominator as it is, sec a plus tan a. Copy the denominator as it is. Is this clear? Now I think this will be in the form of a square minus b square, right? This is our simple algebra format. So you can write sec a minus tan a, put it inside the bracket. So our this plus is over here, this circled plus, okay? I have kept this one in bracket. And now a square minus b square can be written as a plus b and a minus b. Right? A plus b, a minus b for this one. A square minus b square will be a plus b, a minus b. And copy the denominator as it is, 1 plus sec a plus tan a. Are you clear up to this? This is super, super clear, right? Now take common. We need to take common. Look at over here. We do have sin a, sec a minus tan a. Let me repeat it again. We do have sec a minus tan a over here and plus in the middle. And we do have sec plus tan, sec minus tan. I think this one is common, right? The circled one. Look at here. Sec a minus tan a, sec a minus tan a. It is in the both side of plus sign. So you can take this as common. So let me write the common part with red, okay? Sec a minus tan a, this has been taken as common. Look at this clearly. And after you take common, look at here. If you take sec minus tan common from here, only one will be left, right? Because there was only one sec minus tan. And this plus sign, circled wala, right? Circled plus sign. And the right part, as you have taken this as common, we only have this as left, right? So it will be now sec a plus tan a, which is our left part. This part has been written over here. Are you clear? And in the denominator part, we do have 1 plus sec a plus tan a. Are you clear? So I think these two are getting cancelled. Look at here. This is 1 plus sec plus tan, and this is also 1 plus sec plus tan. You can cancel these two. These two are getting cancelled, right? Now we have only red part left, and our red part is, let me write at the top, okay? It is now sec a minus tan a. Only this is left, right? Only this is left. So you can write sec as 1 by cos a, right? And you can write tan as sine by cos. Is this clear? So we are having both denominator as cos a cos a. So write a single cos a for both. And 1 minus sine a will be at the numerator part. Right? Because both